There's around 3,000 human-made satellites in working order around Earth. However, if the debris of old and damaged satellites are taken into account, the number increases dramatically. Ever since the Soviet Union launched the very first artificial satellite into orbit in 1957, various countries around the world have sought to compete, and satellites today are used for communication, navigation, and exploration. Satellites are often visible passing overhead as the sunlight reflects back towards the Earth. One of them is impossible to miss, the largest satellite currently in orbit, the International Space Station. However, these satellites are relatively unexciting in comparison to the mystery surrounding one very old dark satellite. The Black Knight satellite is claimed by some conspiracy theorists to be an object approximately 13,000 years old of extraterrestrial origin orbiting Earth in near polar orbit. It's been identified as an alien satellite, and even though there are images of this object, many remain skeptical about its purpose and origin. The discovery of the Black Knight satellite is perhaps one of the most famous objects to orbit our planet. This artificial satellite has caused major media interest since the late 50s, and it's become one of the most talked about objects in space. First thought to be a Russian spy satellite, the Black Knight has gripped the interest of millions worldwide. According to monitoring agencies around the world, the Black Knight has been transmitting radio signals for over 50 years now. The USA and the Soviet Union have shown particular interest in this unidentified space object. Since its discovery, this satellite has interested countries such as Sweden and enthusiasts worldwide. One of them is a ham radio operator who apparently decoded a series of signals received from the UFO satellite and interpreted it as a star chart centered on the Epsilon Boot star system, and that the Black Knight originated from this system 13,000 years ago. The first apparent part of this story begins with signals heard by Nikola Tesla, a brilliant inventor who spent most of his career in the USA. He was an electrical engineer and produced works which explored the idea of radio and wireless transmissions. In 1899, he reportedly intercepted a signal unlike any of the natural sources from Earth, such as electrical storms that he'd already investigated in his experiments. Instead, he announced that regular signals must be coming from an intelligent outside source, potentially inhabitants of Mars. Tesla never claimed to have heard signals from a satellite orbiting Earth. Today, there are those who say he was listening to a transmission from an orbiting satellite of unknown origin, later called by some the Black Knight. In 1957, Dr. Luis Corralos of the Communications Ministry in Venezuela photographed it while taking pictures of Sputnik 2 as it passed over Caracas. The strange thing was that unlike the Sputnik 1 and 2, the Black Knight satellite orbited Earth from east to west. Sputnik 1 and 2 orbited west to east using Earth's natural rotation to maintain orbit. The story of the Black Knight made its media debut in the 1940s. The St. Louis Dispatch and the San Francisco Examiner wrote about the satellite on May 14, 1954. The Time magazine wrote about it on the 7th of March 1960. A few years later, the Black Knight seemed to have made another appearance when American newspapers reported in 1960 that there was an unusual object in polar orbit. By then, both superpowers had satellites in equatorial orbit, but polar orbit meant the satellite could see every part of the Earth, yet neither country admitted owning it. In the 1960s, the Black Knight was located once again in polar orbit. Astronomers and scientists calculated the object's weight to be over 10 tons, which would be at that time the heaviest artificial satellite to orbit our planet. The Black Knight's orbit was unlike any other object orbiting Earth, as it was moving twice as fast when compared to any other man-made spacecraft. There's also several reports that the Grumman Aircraft Corporation gave much importance to this mysterious satellite. On September 3rd, 1960, 7 months after the satellite was first detected by radar, a tracking camera at Grumman Aircraft Corporation's Long Island factory took a photograph of the Black Knight. At that point, people all over the world started identifying the object in the sky, which could be seen as a red light moving at higher speed compared to other satellites in an east-to-west orbit. The Grumman Aircraft Corporation formed a committee to study the data received from the observations made, but nothing was made public. Any story or conspiracy theory to have credibility, it always helps to get someone high profile on board. In the case of the Black Knight, Project Mercury astronaut Gordon Cooper is a prime example. Cooper announced seeing many UFOs throughout his career. Cooper joined the Air Force in 1949, with his first flight assignment in Germany. There, he says, for several days in a row in 1951, he and his fellow pilots sighted metallic saucer-shaped vehicles. In an interview in 1980, he said that he believed these crafts to come from a technologically advanced civilization. He went on to say, "From my association with aircraft and spacecraft, I think I have a pretty good idea of what everyone on this planet has and their performance capabilities, and I'm sure some of the UFOs are not from anywhere on Earth." Another UFO incident Cooper was involved in while in the Air Force took place at Edwards Air Force Base in California in 1957. There he was a test pilot and project manager. On May the 3rd, he had a crew setting up a camera system on a dry lake bed for filming rocket launches. Cooper was not present during the incident. However, two of his crew members described seeing a saucer-like craft hover over them and land 50 yards away. The craft extended three landing gears from its underside and settled on the lake bed in complete silence. As the men approached the craft, it took off, again emitting no noise. So when it was claimed that Gordon Cooper saw green lights belonging to the Black Knight on his pioneering Mercury mission into Earth's orbit, with ground control radar also picking up something inexplicable, it's often believed to be true. The crew of Space Shuttle Orbiter Endeavour photographed an unusual object in low Earth orbit but not polar orbit. These images are often labelled as the most definitive proof of this satellite. However, on more careful analysis, this strange structure seems more like a piece of space debris. In actual fact, this black object is probably a thermal blanket that became dislodged during an EVA. Mission STS-88 was the first American mission to begin construction on the International Space Station. The Russians had already placed the Zara module in orbit, so this mission was to connect Zara to the American Unity module. The crew achieved all objectives of their mission, including installing handrails and testing a safety device to prevent astronauts drifting into space should they become detached. However, there were a few hitches along the way. Initial alignment of the modules did not quite work, so as the shuttle's robotic arm loosened its grip to try again, several items floated away, including the thermal blanket covering, which is the mysterious-looking image captured. This isn't the only strange thing that has been witnessed in space. In July 1984, Russian cosmonauts aboard the space station Soyuz 7 were on day 155 of their mission. This was also the day the group reported strange lights and beings. According to Commander Oleg Atkov and cosmonaut Vladimir Sololiov, the space station was completely bathed in a mesmerizing orange light. It appeared to enter from outside the space station. For a short period of time, the orange light was so bright that it blinded the crew. When their vision returned, each one looked out the porthole for the source of the light, looking specifically for a possible explosion. They knew the Soyuz 7 had suffered previous fires, but what the crew saw was more incomprehensible than the orange light. All of the cosmonauts reported seeing the faces of seven angels who were hovering just outside the space station. They told ground control they were humanoid in appearance, having faces and bodies that looked human, but also having wings and halos. These beings kept peace with the space station for 10 minutes before vanishing. On day 167, the crew was then joined by another team of three from the Soyuz T-12 spacecraft. Shortly after joining them, the Soyuz 7 was once again bathed in a warm orange light. They immediately looked out the portholes and once again were joined by angelic beings. According to the cosmonauts, they were the size of an airliner. This incident was deemed top secret by the old Soviet Union, and the crew was cautioned not to speak of the event publicly. All the cosmonauts reported seeing a smiling angel. While some may dismiss the incident as fatigue due to an extended stay in space, there was more than one crew that saw the beings. After this strange incident occurred, the crew went on to stay in the vessel for a record-breaking 237 days. Across the Atlantic in America, the US space program brought its own spat of curious incidents. In 1966, two bright red glowing objects captured the attention of astronauts Young and Collins as they circled the Earth. At the time, they had ventured further into space than any other human. Suddenly, both astronauts were amazed to find they were no longer alone. Two bright red glowing objects now occupied the same orbital path. The astronauts immediately informed Mission Control, who in turn requested further information. In their words, "If you can get a bearing, maybe we can track them down." Just at that particular moment, astronaut Young radios back. They just disappeared. The official verdict attributed the sighting to space junk discarded from an unmanned Saturn rocket earlier that month. A simple explanation, but one that fails to explain the erratic movements of the objects as they left orbit and disappeared so easily. The astronauts were adamant these were not stars, and it's difficult to image what man-made device of that time could emit a glowing red light so far out there in space. So that was the Black Knight satellite and other strange encounters that have occurred in space. I'd love to know your thoughts on this subject, so don't forget to drop a comment. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe for more Countdown videos.